Hey everyone, it's Charlotte. 皆さんこんにちは、チョコちゃんです。So, first of all, Merry Christmas! Yay! It's December and Christmas is just around the corner. So today I thought I would do a fun little vlog and show you how we set up our Christmas tree with the kids. Now, yes, we did actually manage to bring our Christmas tree from America and I packed a whole box of my favorite ornaments and plan to use them here and hope to carry on this tradition with my family. So before we begin, I did actually want to talk to you a little bit about the history of the Christmas tree because some of you might not really know about its origins or maybe the reason why we put a Christmas tree up in the Western world. So a Christmas tree is an evergreen tree, like a fir tree that's, you know, always green year round. And there was originally like a pagan tradition in like European countries, especially like in Scandinavia, as far as my research goes, where they believed that the evergreen tree symbolized eternal life. So it dates back to as far back as Egyptian, ancient Chinese, and Hebrew times, where they believed that wreaths and garlands and evergreen trees represented eternal life. Sorry, the kids are screaming in the background because they're playing. Anyway, so it was common among pagan Europeans to put this in their house. And because they also believed that the evergreen tree warded off demons and the devil. It's much like maybe the tradition of putting onigawara on a roof in Japan, or like, for example, dragons on tops of roofs at like a temple here. So then when Europeans began converting into Christianity, they kind of kept this tradition because it kind of fit with the theme of like eternal or everlasting life, which has to do with Christianity and Jesus, the fact that Jesus died for the sins of humanity and allowed us to have eternal life in heaven. So it is believed. So this tradition of the tree representing eternal life seemed to fit well with that because Christmas time is the time that Christians celebrate the birth of Jesus. But then the actual Christmas tree as we've come to know it today with ornaments on it and decorations and lights actually comes from West Germany or the western part of Germany. So what they would do is in Germany, the tree represented for people the paradise tree or a fir tree because it's the only tree that's green at that time of year. And these were live trees, of course, that they would cut down. And they would put apples on it. So like real apples, they would hang on it. If you've ever seen traditional pictures of like an old Christmas tree, it often has apples and candles on it. So the apples represented the apples from the tree of knowledge that Adam and Eve ate. The candles then also represent the light of Christ, of Jesus, and the light that he brought to this world. So it is believed. So this all really is kind of a religious thing. But nowadays, it's a lot more secular. A lot of people just have the Christmas tree because that's what has always traditionally been associated with Christmas. So the custom was widespread throughout the Lutheran church in the 18th century. And then when Germans began making their way to America, they brought this tradition with them. And pretty soon everyone basically started doing this. It's kind of interesting because also in one of my previous videos, I talked about the birthday cake as we know it, kind of also coming from Germany. So German culture, whether you knew it or not, has actually spread around the world in some very surprising and interesting ways. A lot of my ancestors are from Germany, so this tradition kind of fits perfectly with my ancestral heritage. Nowadays, we see a lot of Christmas trees with round ornaments on them. Apparently, that was more started in Britain, in Great Britain. They had a lot of glass blowing factories, and so the round ornaments are traditionally typically made of glass. Anyway, just a little interesting tidbit there. Actually, in my research, I found that the Christmas tree was introduced by Western missionaries to Japan in the 19th and 20th century. And in Japan, apparently, they were decorated with intricate paper designs, maybe like kirikami or origami, perhaps. So that's interesting. Maybe I'll get the kids to make some origami to decorate our Christmas tree with later. That's just a little bit of a background for you on the Christmas tree. And now we're gonna set it up. The kids have been begging me to do this for a long time, and so finally we're gonna do it. So I hope you enjoy watching us set up our Christmas tree. Okay, guys, who wants to help set up the Christmas tree?
I want to! Yay.
How about you, baby? Oh, you're already looking in the box of ornaments. Ooh, here's our ornaments. And a big pine cone from America. Wow.
Wow, that's big.
Yep. So we've got a mixture of ornaments here, the traditional, more German style ones, or European, as I explained.
And look at mine.
We've got some garlands here, and we've got our lights. But first we gotta actually get the tree out of its packaging and unfold it. So let's do that now.
First we gotta get the Christmas tree out of the box here. It's not as tall as the big ones, but it's perfect for a Japanese size house. Now your job is gonna be to help me to open up all these branches, okay? Okay, finally we got it all straightened out. Okay, so I think we're gonna keep it in the corner this year. How does that look? Does it look good there? This is kind of like our holiday section. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is put the lights on. Who wants to help me put the lights on?
I want to.
Okay. First, let's plug them in to make sure that they actually work. Woo! They work!
Woo!
Right?
Wow!
Wow, baby! Isn't it cool? Christmas is coming. Were you a good boy this year? You guys were good. You were helpful and you moved halfway across the world. You're being a really helpful brother and doing so well in school.
Yeah. Oh, it's Christmas. My main chair. This is what I made in your chair, I think.
Now, traditionally, we put a star on the top of the Christmas tree. This represents, I guess, the star that showed everyone where Jesus was being born.
Yes.
So, Next, we're gonna hang the garlands on.
Is this the garland?
Mm-hmm. Nice thing about having like a fake tree is that you can adjust the needles. We also got these little stars.
Oh,
stars up here, and
like
that will go up here in the middle.
Now we'll put our ornaments on.
Here you go,
Rebe.
Hang an ornament on.
Oh, I want to hang that one.
Ooh.
This is the worst. Let's see. Oh, here's where we're living.
Mm-hmm. Let's hang it on the tree now. Look, we've even got a little Ampaman Santa-san.
Thank you.
Yeah. You want to hang that one too?
Okay.
Got our little mushrooms.
Mama,
here you go, baby. You can hang the Hakusai one that we have. This is good luck in China and Japan.
Hakusai.
It's got a lot of leaves in it, so it has like 1,000 leaves, so that will bring 1,000 coins of fortune to you.
Here it is. It's the polar bear.
Here,
the polar bear is happy.
Today is Christmas. Yay!
So when you have little kids, you don't put out your nicest ornaments, or you put those ones at the top of the tree where the kids can't get to them. Just a little tip.
Reindeer.
He said it.
Santa
will be happy.
Oh, we've got another reindeer too. Oh, I want to hang it up. Ooh.
Here,
you can
hang
up this blue reindeer.
Hey,
what's this one?
That's a magic elephant.
Ooh.
Ice cream.
In America, or maybe around the world, a lot of ornaments are traditionally passed down in families and they have a lot of meanings to them. For example, if you traveled somewhere, maybe you got something and it has special meaning. For example, this is actually from the Mononoke Hime, the Studio Ghibli movie, and I got this when I first came to Japan because that's one of my favorite movies.
Hey, hot dog man!
This is one that we got in Paris! Aww!
Oh, this one is really special. This was made by Leo's first teacher ever, and she gave it to the class as a gift one year.
So she made it herself. Okay, here's the finished product. This is what it looks like.
Happy side. Oh, and we got the lion down here. Let's put him up a little bit higher. Don't want him to fall on the floor. Oh, now for the final thing, we have to put the tree skirt on. This is the tree skirt to make it look nice. And later, the presents will go here. Ta-da! Yay, it's Christmas! And then just to put the finishing touches, we'll hang our little stockings. This was made by my grandmother. This is my very first stocking that I had since I was a little kid. This is a stocking I got when I found out I was pregnant with Leo. And here's one that we got for Ray. And here's one for Mucky. So there's one for every member of the family. Cute. And then we've just got a little Christmas display here. I made these little felted acorns. I felted these out and put little caps that I collected from the wild. So here's the final decorated room. I found this cute little light at Daiso, which is really neat. A little reindeer for Nara. And we've got our stockings. Hee hee, cute. Festive and cheerful. I think that's why we have all these lights at Christmas time, because it kind of brings a light into the dark of winter. Oh, and we do have a little bit of a New Year's set up here too.
Okay, so that was how we decorated for Christmas this year, our first Christmas in Japan as a family. So what did you guys think? Would you like to decorate your house this way? What are some traditions that you like to do at this time of year if you don't celebrate Christmas? Do you do something special for New Year's time, for example? Let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to hear your ideas. So thank you so much for watching, and please remember to like this video. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already for more content like this. And I would so appreciate it if you left a comment down below. It really does help out my channel, and I also just love hearing from you guys. So thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.
Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please like, subscribe, comment, share, and enjoy. Until next time, bye!